Hey everyone, it's Coach Mo Faul here, your kick-ass career coach and bring your soul to work strategist, I'm going to call it. I'm here with Yuliya. Hello, Yuliya.
Hello.
Yuliya is a wonderful kick-ass client of mine and an absolute gorgeous human being. And I wanted her to share her story. Yuliya hails right now from the Czech Republic. And she lives and works there. We'll let her tell you a little bit more about her story. But this is one of the most fantastic stories. And Yuliya, as you know, we talked about a little bit. Your story is so relatable to so many of the women who I work with and talk to about what their struggles are. So I'm really looking forward to you sharing just your background a little bit and then where you were when we first started talking and where you were when you had your clarity call and just a little bit about some of that. So why don't you give us some background on who you are and what your education is and what your work field is. Just a little bit about you.
Yeah, sure. So I'm originally from Ukraine. I moved to Czech Republic 7 years ago and I have been working in IT in Ukraine and then in Czech Republic for last 10 years. And I also studied IT, so it was like logical step.
Yep.
But I was always like good average at work. And sometimes worse than average, let's say. And I was really unhappy with work and I was like, oh, there has to be something more to life. There has to be something more. Like some people are achieving something and I'm just staying in this mediocre life and I have no satisfaction. What should I do with it?
Yes.
And so I had this thoughts and little voice telling me that I have to do something for quite a while, but I ignored it.
Yeah,
I successfully ignored it for 10 years. I actually signed up for Clarity Call half year before I took the course, but I canceled it. And I was like, oh, no, I'm not doing this. There is something more important right now.
Uh-huh.
So I didn't do it. But this voice started to become stronger and stronger. And at some point I said, okay, I'm not losing anything. I will book this Clarity Call. It's free. Let's see what they're going to offer me.
So tell me when you canceled it the first time, and now that you say that, I remember that. When you canceled it the first time, what was really the dominant voice, the gremlin voice that was really talking to you? What was going on there?
I was like, why do I really need this? It's okay, like I have it now. But what those people can even, they cannot help me. It's all like, they will just take my money or not take my money, but waste my time and don't bring me any value.
Right.
So I was like, whatever, let's just cancel.
Yeah, right. And then the voice that you mentioned, as you know, in working with me, that's your inner being trying to get your attention. So sometimes, as you know, because you had this in the work that we did together, sometimes the inner being helps create noise in your reality to get your attention. And sometimes it's just that little voice that's kind of whispering to you, why not try it? So you finally listened to that, and let's talk a little bit about listening to that inner voice. How did that feel?
Yeah, so I was like unhappy at work and also in my personal relationships, and so basically there was nothing bad but nothing good either in my life.
Yeah.
So yes, I have to change this and. I was signed up already for your newsletters and stuff, and this offer to book Clarity Call kept on coming, and I said, okay, I'll give it a try this time. Just I don't lose anything.
Right.
So I booked it, and I'm so happy about it.
So on the Clarity Call, as you know, we dive into what's really not going on for you, and. Yeah. And let's just say that what you talked about, so it was like average, life wasn't horrible, but it was like average, and you're thinking, is this all that life is going to be for me? So one of the things that we do in the clarity calls, you know, is we really help you understand what's really going on. And we don't sugarcoat it. We don't make it feel better than it really is, because everyone, I believe, and you know this from the working with me, everyone has the right and the destiny to be happy with who they are and feel awesome. And what happens, and you know this, and you'll talk a little bit more about this, all of these voices start telling you what to do and how to feel. So you have your clarity call, and you finally realize, well, maybe there's a strategy that could help me.
Yeah. During clarity call, I really gain confidence that yes, this is what I have to do. But then it comes the question of price.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And immediately my voice like, oh, no. I cannot spend this money. Yes. No way. I never spend this money in my whole life.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. We have to end this call. Oh, no, we are ending. But we ended the call without actually like confirming anything from my side, but I said I'll think about it. We exchanged a few emails, like I was still not sure, and I wanted it really, really much, but I just could not imagine spending this money for this. And I was like, oh, what am I doing? Who are these people even? Oh my God, they'll just take all my money from my card, and I don't even know them, what am I doing?
Right.
And the other side was like, you have to do it. And yeah, so I just took my time. I slept over with these thoughts. I reached out to some other coaches, not coaches, but some bloggers and stuff, for advice. What to do? What would they do? And they said, at some point, your inner voice will be so strong that you will not be able not to act.
Yes.
And I realized that this is the moment when I have to act.
Yeah.
Great for that.
Yeah. And so you came into the 12-week workshop, and as I remember, you were in this crossroad. You felt that there was two directions for you. One was continue a career that you were trained in and that you were good at, but it wasn't thrilling you and it wasn't your passion. Next road was pursue the writing and the blogging that you really felt happy and joyful about.
Yeah.
And as you know, when people have a profession and an education and experience, to me, I call that the treasure chest. Like you have something to offer the world that you're trained in. So let's figure out how this fits in. So talk a little bit about what you were really kind of like determined to do when you got into working with me, and just let's just talk about what happened in there.
Yeah, right. So I got to the point at work that I didn't want to work at all. I was taking walks, I was being late, I was leaving work earlier, and I was just thinking, okay, I have a talent for writing. I have to just start writing. But hey, I won't have money. Like no writer has money right away from the start. Mm-hmm. What should I do? Oh my God, I can't stand this work. What should I do? And yeah, when I came to this course, I had a clear vision that I'm gonna quit my work and I'm gonna start writing and earning money from that. At the same time, hating work, my current work. And yeah. I remember one of our calls when I said that I cannot work at my work, but I cannot write either. Something happened. I'm blocked. Mo, help me.
Yeah.
And then you shifted my mindset because you said, your favorite phrase, as we do everything, we do anything.
Yes.
And yeah, you told me you have to start reaching for something at your current work. You have to start loving your current work. Then you will start loving everything else and be able to do so. So, you told me like, show up at work, show up full of energy, vibrant and happy, and see what happens. And on the other calls, you told me, and maybe you should get a promotion. Yeah. And I was like, even thinking, oh my God, doesn't she hear me? I don't want to like that. What is this advice? Like, but then it stayed with me, your this praise. Maybe you should get a promotion. And it actually, it really lifted me up. I started to come to work like I own it. It's mine. People started to raise around me like so happy and wondering why I'm happy, why I'm so happy. I said, oh, I don't have reasons to be unhappy. I started to have idea, maybe I should get a promotion. And I just thought about this, and like within a few weeks I got small. It was not that big, but it was a promotion, my first step. And I was like, oh, maybe I could really advance in this career and have writing like aside or somehow in parallel or somehow like make it work together.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, so in the end, I changed my direction from completely quitting my job and start writing. And I do both now.
So I remember a couple of weeks in after we kind of had that little transformative discussion, and you decided, so I want to just say a few things. You decided to be coachable. You said, I'm here, and which is one of the reasons why it's an investment, because if you paid $100 for my advice, you'd be like, what does she know?
Mm-hmm.
I only paid $100. I'm going to keep doing my own thing. There's a purpose for having a high investment, because then you're paying attention. And if you're paying that much and investing that much in yourself, first of all, the universe changes because you now value yourself. All of a sudden, you're able to give yourself the possibility of maybe I can be more valuable. It just changes the entire equation. You were coachable. You could have rejected everything I said and said, what do you know? But then you're here in the workshop getting coached and paying good money for it. So you said, you know what? I'm going to go for it, because what's working, what's not, what me doing it is not working. Yep. So all of a sudden, people notice something different about you, and all of a sudden the promotion. And I remember you were a little bit doubtful, but then you're like, well, maybe I should just go for it. And these people that have this job aren't any smarter than me. As a matter of fact, they're less smart than me. I think I remember you kind of talking about that. The key thing is that you were also blocked on being a writer, right?
Yeah, totally. Yeah, it's as you said, I was worried also about this promotion. I wanted it, but then when I got it, I was like, oh my God, I can't handle it. I'm handling it until now perfectly.
Yeah.
And yeah, I couldn't write. I was writing one article per month, maybe even less. Now I write every day.
Mm-hmm.
My audience is growing. I get likes, nice comments, followers, and everybody just says such warm words.
Yes.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I remember first few blog posts that you wrote when you were in the program, in the Kick-Ass program, and you shared it with the ladies in the group, which is another great benefit. You have all these women around the world supporting you and saying, oh, Yuliya, this is fantastic. This is such great writing. This is so inspirational. And you wrote about your journey. You wrote about your journey back to yourself.
Yeah. Well, the whole blog, my blog is about this journey to myself.
Yeah.
And yeah, I remember sharing my first articles. I didn't know if anybody will ever like it. Mm-hmm. I didn't know if I'm writing some good stuff or just, you know, talking to myself some bullshit. And this safe place, this group of amazing women who are supportive, is just perfect place for growth, because I'm safe. I know I won't be judged or something.
Yes.
I'm supported and I get confidence. I was getting confident more and more every day. I posted a post and I received support, and I said, oh, so maybe I'm writing good stuff. I should do this more.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Mm-hmm. So do you mind if I just talk a little bit about the boyfriend thing, just a little bit? Because I think this was really interesting. We don't have to mention names or anything like that.
Go ahead.
There was someone from the past came back.
Yeah, that's right.
And tell what you feel comfortable telling. But I found that this was a very interesting aspect of your transformational
journey. Okay. I don't have problems telling this at all.
Okay.
So I dated a man, like, it's now 3 years ago or something. I was madly in love with him, and he actually pushed me, somehow triggered this start of this growth. So I was really in depression after he left. So when I a little bit expanded, I wanted him back all the time. So when I expanded, he returned, actually. Was like out of the blue, and I was like, oh my God, what's happening? But he left after 1 week again, because the first time he also left. And I was again down in depression. But then I said, wait a minute. No, I'm not giving him such power over me. I was so great. I was doing so great. I reached such, I made such achievements. Yeah. And I will cry over some guy who doesn't know what he wants. No way. And actually after that, I forgot him completely. So I couldn't forget about him like 2 or 2.5 years, and I forgot him completely in a few weeks.
Yeah, yeah. You specifically when you went through your journey, you mentioned when you got to a level of expansion, all of a sudden this guy comes back. And the way that I saw your journey unfold for you is that you were ready to put closure on it. And as before, perhaps your expansion wasn't at the point where you were ready to put closure on it. And he pops back in to help you put closure on it, not only for him, but for you, to realize that you're your own person and your happiness doesn't depend on a man being in your life. And to me, that's such great clarity. I mean, such power. There's so many women around the world who are looking for their happiness through their partner.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. I really have a lot to say about this, because my whole life I was not happy with my work. So I was looking for happiness in partner all my life, and it all has changed within a few weeks and following a few months. I'm happy with myself, and I always wanted this, to be happy with myself, not depend on anybody, but I couldn't do it. And I expanded so much that just my life is good.
Yeah, that's so awesome. Yeah. so awesome. So one of the interesting things is so in the kick-ass group, as you mentioned, it's a very safe place.
Yeah.
And you, in writing your blogs, sharing your blogs and sharing your own personal journey, I know that that inspired the other women in the workshop also. And when you went through your relationship closure issue, so many women could relate to that.
Yeah.
And your ability to stand in your truth about it was just super, super inspiring.
Yeah. And when I shared my childhood story for the first time, I could not speak about this with anybody until I was able to post it in this group. And when I was accepted in this group, I said, okay, so it's not so bad as I imagined in my head, so I can share it to the world. And I actually started to speak up with friends about this. I don't mind this anymore. I started to write more and more about this, getting open. It's and of course getting more confident.
Mm-hmm. Right. You know, when we have our story, not only our current story, so you have your work transformation, you have your personal transformation, you have your relationship transformation, all of that is your transformation, it's your story, and you're literally telling your story through your blog. Now, you know, and having worked with me, that I really encourage women to tell their story. Because when we have our truth come out, especially when we speak it, you know, we open the throat chakra and we can speak it, or we write it, we can express it. It releases so much of our own power. Yeah. Tell me how that feels, because you went from no voice to big.
That's exactly what I wanted to say. I was unable to speak up anywhere. At work, about myself, I was getting all shy when somebody asks me about my childhood story or about some past relationships or whatever.
Yeah.
I would not stand up for myself at work. I didn't have bad conditions, but anyway, like whenever something I didn't like happened at work, I didn't speak up. I was just, that's okay. I can live with it.
Yeah.
And I was living with it. And within last few months, starting with the course, I gained so huge confidence in myself. I'm speaking up at work. People are really, really counting my opinion. They are really like relating to it. I mean, respecting, and actually coming to me and trying to for me to approve some things. And like, that's amazing. And I grow in my blog as well. And my articles becoming more confident and more popular within people.
Yes.
And I have never felt so confident in my whole life.
So good.
Yeah.
I think anyone watching this interview, Yuliya, is going to be like, this woman is radiating confidence and happiness and inner joy. And you know, when we're on the clarity call, the one thing that we like to ask is, what does your future look like or feel like? And most people, when they talk about it a little bit, even if it's very sketchy and not specific, when we say, well, how does that feel to have that? And it's like, it feels free. It feels like joy. It feels like happiness. Oh, I don't even know if that's possible. And clearly that's really, if I say, Yuliya, in the next 12 weeks, I'm going to take you from this to that. How believable was it that you'd feel like this in 12 weeks?
Oh, I didn't believe it at all. I just knew that I have to do something different than I was doing for 10 years. So I have to do it. But I was, nothing ever worked for me. Nothing really changed me, transformed me. This is going to be a failure again. Yeah, those were.
Right. And now, as I'm continuing to watch your journey, you're in the kick-ass grad group, which is a separate phase. All the graduates who you only knew, those who were in the work with you. So now you get to see other women who have been through the journey, other women in Europe, around the world. I think when you were in the program, there's a woman in Japan, a woman in Israel. And then I don't know if the woman in Switzerland was there when you were still there or not. So it's so great to have basically an international sisterhood of kick-ass women who are all expanding and finding their truth. And as you know, like, it doesn't stop. The journey continues, and the next blog exposed to more people, and the next promotion, and the next this and that, and
this is only. This is so great, because it's like emergency support system. You
know? Yes.
Like, whenever I feel down, I know that I have to share it in Kick-Ass group, and I'll get all support, and I let it go. And this is what happens, and I'm trying to be supportive to other women as well, and they are very supportive to me as well, and it's just great. Nobody has such privilege except me. I'm feeling low. I will just ask Kika's grads.
That's right. And you know, the interesting thing is, so as you go through it, as you go through the work with me, like, you now have a toolkit. You have certain things that you can now go to and you can do, and they'll help shift you back to where you want to feel.
Yeah.
Everyone who's in the grad group with you has that, but it doesn't mean it's so easy to find it when you're not having a great day or hour or half day or maybe something upset yesterday. As you know, before we got into this interview, I was just commenting about some comments that you made on other people, other women in there having a little bit bumpy road. And what you wrote is just so, so perfect and so wonderful to encourage them. Having a place with 100% unconditional support is a pretty unique place to be. And we got to thank Facebook, I think, for having the platform to allow us to have that space.
Yeah, we got to thank thank you.
Absolutely. So, Yuliya, what's the name of your blog? Because I'm going to put the link down below. So everyone watching this, I'll put the link down below so you can read Yuliya's work. What's the name of your blog?
It's yuliyaonlinetogether.com.
Mm-hmm. So good.
It's called actually Life Balance, but it's the link is yuliyaonline.com.
Yeah, it's so good. And you write about all of these aspects of your journey, and you have some really cute ways of sometimes talking about making a choice of food in a restaurant or just different things that appear to be normal that you find to be good reflections of your journey and the transformation you've made.
Oh, yeah. you read that.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I just, like, I have some random thought and I have it for a day or two, and then all of a sudden I have a whole article in my head.
Yes.
And I write it down and I'm trying to explain it in the most easy way. I like to compare to something which will really show how it works.
Yes. Well, you've done a brilliant job in doing that. And I do love reading your blog because it starts out as like this simple reflection, and then it becomes this very deep aspect of how we live and how we transform and what our soul is really all about in this life.
Yeah.
And I think your overriding theme is all we have to do is love ourselves.
Yeah. That's right. You got it right. I think it all starts with self-love, with accepting yourself as you are, and everything else will be just attracted to you, everything what you need.
Yes. It's so good. And as you know, in the work that I do, I'm totally with you on that. And in loving ourselves, in having that practice, that regular condition of our lives of loving each other, loving ourselves so that we can love others and work well. There's forgiveness and there's moving through the past and healing. And you've done such a fantastic, I'll say job with, I don't mean it like that, but you've done, you've approached that all with such great courage. And we don't have to reveal everything here, but you've had really, really awesome, courageous moments where you've healed yourself, you've accepted yourself, you've accepted and loved yourself. And watching that to me as a coach is a true gift and blessing to watch you go through that journey. And I know the river of doubt between the clarity call and coming in the workshop and then doing the work took that inner voice to convince you that this is what you needed. And I'm just blessed that the angels came around you and you trusted me and my team and my approach, because it makes me so happy to see you smiling. And every time I see one of your blog posts, I get tickled that you're writing and you're being creative and all of your soul's energy and talents are just pouring forth.
Yeah, well, that's right. I can say something about this forgiveness. You have really, really nice tools and advices on forgiveness, and I use them all. I really needed it. And before I could forgive myself, my past, my childhood, my past hurts, I could not move forward.
Yes.
I had to do it, and it was such relief for me. I transformed from always unhappy to always happy. I dropped that deep sadness which was with me for so many years. It's amazing.
Wow. I mean, I'm very touched by that. Very touched by that.
I'm very thankful.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. Wow. Well, what a journey you have had. And I can't wait to keep watching you continue to be yourself and to express and to be more in the world and just keep being. That's what we're all here for. self-love, community, and expansion. So I'll remind you that your expansion as a person is helping the entire planet expand.
Yeah, that's right.
And, yeah, and not only your journey, but the fact that you're sharing your journey and writing about it and sharing it here on this interview is allowing others that little inner voice to be recognized and say, oh, maybe I could follow the path as well. So yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing your journey. Is there anything you'd like to share as we wrap up to any woman who might be watching this, or maybe speaking to your past self, little words of encouragement? If you were talking to her now, what would you say?
I would just have one advice. Stop ignoring that little voice. Follow it. It will lead you to greatness.
Those are great words of wisdom. And you know, you've heard a lot of my story in the workshop too. I share some of the things that I've gone through, and it is that inner voice that guides us, because that is our divinity. It's our God source. Whatever we believe, that's our connection with our true self.
Exactly.
And all the way from Prague in the Czech Republic to Florida in the United States, hours apart, but completely, completely together on this planet in our soul's journey. It's just a delight to see you and to know that your journey is a happy one. And to go from completely unhappy to completely happy, that's like, oh my God.
That's
right.
That's me.
Oh, great. Yes, indeed. Indeed. Well, we will continue to see you in the grad group, Yuliya. Thank you very much for your time today and for sharing your story here and also in your blog. And folks, yuliyaonline.com. We'll have the blog link here as well. And just God bless you and namaste.
Thank you, Mo. Thank you.